Hi, how are you? This is Brando, and this time I will talk about some expressions and its differences. For example, we have first in time, okay? At the end, and in the end. These four expressions are different, and I'll give you the definition of each one of them and also some examples for you to be able to know the differences between one and the others. I will start with on time. Okay, on time means to be punctual, okay, not late. If something happens on time, it happens at the same time that was planned. For example, the train left, the 11:45 train left on time, which means that the train left at 11:45. Try to get to school on time. If school starts at 7, try to get there at 7, try to be on time, okay? The opposite of on time is late. Now we have the in time, okay? It's a little bit different from on time. It means just in time or soon enough. For example, will you be home in time for dinner? It means that if dinner starts at 9, are you going to be there soon enough for dinner? Like at 8:45 or something like that. Okay, not at 9 exactly, but a little bit before, just in time to be to have dinner. Another example would be, I'm in a hurry, I want to get home in time for the game. The opposite is too late, okay? It doesn't mean that this means too early, but it's just a little bit before the time that was planned. If you have something scheduled for 8 p.m. and you get there 10 minutes before, you are in time. If you get there at 10, if it's scheduled for 10 and you're there at 10, you are on time. In time means that you're a little bit you got there a little bit before. Now we have the expression at the end. Okay, it means that the moment when something ends. For example, at the end of the month, at the end of the year, at the end of January, at the end of the game. Okay, by the time the month ends. By the time the game ends, I am going to drink some water at the end of the game. So by the moment the game ends, I am going to drink some water. Okay, that's the way in which you use this. The opposite is at the beginning. You have at the beginning and then you have the opposite at the end. Also, you have the expression in the end. This expression is used when you want to say what the result of something was. Like, for example, we had a lot of problems with the car. We solved it at the end. We solved it in the end. Sorry. We had a lot of problems with the car, and in the end, we could solve them. That you're saying the result of a situation. The situation was that they had problems with the car, and in the end, they could solve them. Also, you have he didn't study for the test. He failed in the end. He didn't study. What's the result? He failed in the end. And the opposite of in the end is at first. Well, this is the way in which you use these expressions: at time, on time, in the end, and at the end. Thank you very much for paying attention. I hope this was useful for you. See you next time.
Hola, soy Brando y en esta ocasión les voy a hablar sobre unas expresiones. Les voy a decir las definiciones y para que sepan las diferencias entre de cada una con la otra. Voy a comenzar con la expresión on time. Y significa puntual, cuando alguien es puntual, cuando alguien llega justo a tiempo. Okay, bueno, justo a tiempo, sino sí, puntual. Como por ejemplo, the 11:45 train left on time. El tren de las 11:45 partió puntualmente. Try to get to school on time. Trata de llegar al colegio puntualmente. El contrario, como les dije anteriormente, es tarde. Si algo estaba planeado para comenzar a las 11 y comienza a las 11, comenzó puntualmente. ¿Okay? La otra expresión sería in time, que significa a tiempo, como justo, suficientemente tiempo. ¿Okay? I'm in a hurry, I want to get home in time for the game. Estoy apurado, quiero llegar a casa a tiempo para el juego. Si el juego comienza a las 9, llegar a tiempo sería a las 8:45, 8:50, justo un poco antes de que el evento o la actividad vaya a comenzar. Will you be home in time for dinner? ¿Llegarás a la casa a tiempo para la cena? Si la cena comienza a las 8, si vas a llegar a tiempo, sería como a las 7:50, más o menos, un poquito antes. Y el contrario sería demasiado tarde. A tiempo y demasiado tarde. La otra expresión sería at the end, al final. Sería el momento en el que algo termina. Expresiones con al final sería at the end of the month, al final del mes. At the end of the year, al final del año. At the end of January, al final de enero. Y at the end of the game, al final del juego. Estas expresiones se utilizan cuando se refiere al final de algo, al final de enero, para el momento en el que termine enero. ¿Okay? Como por ejemplo, I am going to have $1,000,000 at the end of the year. Voy a tener $1,000,000 al final del año. Eso significa que para el momento en el que el año termine, voy a tener $1,000,000. ¿Okay? I am going to drink a lot of water at the end of the game. Voy a tomar mucha agua al final del partido, al final del juego. Eso significa que para cuando termine el juego, yo voy a tomar mucha agua. La otra expresión sería in the end, significa finalmente, y lo utilizamos para hablar del resultado de algún evento. También puede ser al final. Y algunos ejemplos serían we had a lot of problems with the car. We solved it in the end. Nosotros tuvimos muchos problemas con el carro. Los resolvimos al final los resolvimos. Tuvimos muchos problemas, esa es la situación. Y el resultado fue que los resolvimos. He didn't study for the test, he failed in the end. In the end, he failed the test. Él no estudió para el examen y al final lo reprobó. ¿Okay? En este caso, el contrario de al final sería al principio. ¿Okay? Espero les haya gustado, que haya sido muy útil. Esta fue la forma en la que se utilizan las expresiones on time, in time, at the end y in the end. ¿Okay? Muchas gracias. Nos vemos en la próxima.